The Nigerian Minister of State for Petroleum fueled speculation of a cut in production by OPEC Monday, saying more members of the bloc are now open to doing something about the current supply glut.
I think when we met in December, you had blocs that were hardly talking to one another. Everybody was protecting their own positional logic. Now I think you're having cross logic. People are saying, what's the deficiency of your logic versus what is the optimum side of your logic? So people are talking a lot more intellectually now.
OPEC has been trying to force competitors out of business by continuing production to keep world crude prices low, which in turn makes the business less profitable. But just last week, an official of the United Arab Emirates mentioned some OPEC members are now rethinking the strategy. This helped world oil prices surge 12%, the biggest jump since 2009. Fund manager Marvin Fausto says while this makes volatility in oil prices less of a concern for financial markets and overseas Filipino workers in the Middle East, the situation is still problematic.
There are some kind of talks happening in OPEC countries. That is why production might be curtailed a bit. It's not as big as an issue now at the moment, but I think it will be an issue if it continues to go down, particularly on the OFW remittances that will be affected by the Middle East cutting their labor imports from the Philippines.
Nigeria also clarifies while more OPEC members are open to possibly reducing production, an actual decision may still be far off.
But have we gotten to a point where we can say that it's a definite strategy? Whether it's in terms of product volume reduction out of the, or in terms of freezing, no, I don't think we've gotten there.
Nigeria itself is actually hoping to raise its own production from 2.3 million barrels per day to 2.5 million through huge drilling deals, including one with Chevron. Those deals, however, won't likely make much money if crude prices remain so low. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.